Hello, friends. Welcome to another edition of Cooking with Cliff. I am your host, Cliff. But you already knew that. What does eating healthy have to taste so bad? I don't think it should. So I'm going to show you an easy way to make some fish, some Israeli couscous, and some, dare I say, Brussels sprouts. We'll make a nice little quick meal that you can make any night of the week. They say you should have fish 2, maybe 3 times a week. It's very low in points for those who are counting. Very good if you season it right. So let's try a little cooking. Our first side for this week is going to be Israeli couscous. Couscous is a baked wheat. It's got the same size as in most cases as rice. It actually comes even smaller. Israeli couscous is the bigger form. It also resembles a pasta, or has a texture of a pasta, so you could almost replace it in both cases to rice or pasta. I'm going to add some flavor to this, and to do that I'm going to add a little bit of extra virgin olive oil. There's about 2 teaspoons there, and to that I'm going to add some bell peppers and onions. And as you can hear, I have the heat up nice and high. I'm going to turn it down a bit. Just going to try to soften down these vegetables, brown them up a little bit, but mainly just cook out some of the moisture. Israeli couscous does need a little bit of moisture to it. It is very similar to rice, where the ratio is almost 2 to 1. I'm going to replace some of my liquids with, as I've done in the past, Old Faithful, which is the low-sodium vegetable juice. I'm going to add a little bit of salsa, which will add some moisture as well as lots of flavor, which will complement the peppers and the onions that's already in the pan. And then I'll finish it up with some water. So for the first part, just going to keep cooking down my vegetables, get some of the moisture out of it, brown them down a bit, let them soften. The couscous is probably going to be the portion of the dish that's going to take the longest to cook, so it's best to start with that. So I'm just going to continue to stir away, and we'll go from there. All right, my vegetables have now softened down. They're at the point now where they're starting to brown, so I'm going to want to try to get moving quickly with the couscous and with the liquids. So just the same as you would with rice, if you want to try to keep it from sticking, I'm going to add it to my mixture now. I'm going to give it a good stir, incorporate it with the bell peppers and the onion. Try to get some oil on every grain there. That way there it doesn't stick together. Just going to stir a few more times. I have it now on pretty well on a medium heat. It's going to reduce again. So now I'm going to add my salsa. Salsa primarily here is to add a little bit of liquid, but also to add some flavor. I don't want to burn the salsa, so I'm going to move right straight into the vegetable juice. Get that in there. So now what I want to do here is I want to reduce the heat. I want to get this to a boil, and then once it's at a boil, I want to turn it down to a very low heat, and that way there the couscous is going to absorb the liquids. As you can see, it's boiling pretty quick, so I'm going to add a splash of water. These bowls here are about 1/2 cup each, so it was 1/2 cup of couscous, 1/2 cup of salsa, 1/2 cup of vegetable juice, 1/2 cup of bell peppers, and probably about 1/4 cup that I put in there of the water, just to give it as much moisture as I can, but I don't want it to be the point where it's going to be soup. So I'm just going to let that boil for a minute, then I'm going to reduce the heat, and I'm going to give it a cover here. I'll get my cover ready. It's almost to that point. And we have bubbles. So from here, I'm going to reduce the heat. Oh, that's hot. It's going to go down to pretty well 2 on my dial, which is nice and low. I'm going to add a cover to keep all the steam inside. That's going to help cook the couscous and absorb all that moisture. From here, I'm just going to leave it. It's probably going to be sitting there for about 10, maybe 15 minutes. I'm going to keep checking on it, just the same as you would with rice. You'll keep checking it, giving it a stir. At this point, you should probably change your spoon over to a fork. That way there you can fluff the couscous and keep it from sticking together, and try to keep it from basically turning into a mush. So for the next step, we're going to move into steaming some Brussels sprouts.
having trouble climbing the social ladder, is trying to find a date, a humiliating experience. Are you the butt of practical jokes?
Hey, punk!
Are bullies leaving you a few dollars short? Sounds like you need a new image. You need the I'm a cool guy t-shirt. Composed of space-age material, each shirt is handcrafted with 90% polyester and 10% cotton, and is pre-shrunk to suit your every comfort. So now, when life's ordinary misfortunes occur, just say, hey, I'm a cool guy.
Wow, what a cool guy.
Come on, baby.
Yeah.
They don't have the shirt.
Get your I'm a cool guy t-shirt for only $20. Order within the next 30 seconds and receive the I'm number one hat absolutely free. Think of the possibilities this shirt can do for you.
My second side's going to consist of basically making a steamer pot. If you've been to the grocery store or any cooking appliance place, you've probably seen this flying saucer jobby there. That's a steamer basket, usually about $6-7. You can get it metal and plastic. Can't lie, they are a bit of a pain in the ass to clean, especially if it, if you're using something like a potato or something that's going to mush up. It will get in there and it will be a pain, but steamed vegetables are better for you than boiled vegetables. When you boil your vegetables, you're actually boiling all the nutrients out of it. With steaming it, you're cooking it, it cooks quicker, and you're actually locking your nutrients into the vegetable. So you drop that contraption into the pot, add your Brussels sprouts, which can be frozen, you add your lid, that's it. You just leave it. It's on this highest temperature you can get. It doesn't take very long. You keep an eye on it. Basically, to test when it's done, you just stick a fork in it. It's the same as any other vegetable that you boil. That's usually how you tell it. If the fork goes through and feels nice and soft inside, it is done. So let's move on to the main ingredient. Let's move on to our fish. So what I have here is just your ordinary, I guess this isn't an ordinary frying pan. This is actually one that I was given. It's probably intended for pancakes or making sandwiches, but I'm going to use this one because it's going to be the easiest one to allow me to flip the fish. The fish is very delicate, and sometimes it can be a very tedious chore to try to flip it over without breaking. You can use a cooking spray on that. You can also use oil. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to take the oil onto a piece of paper towel. Just going to kind of dab it as if I was putting, Varsol or, if you were, cleaning out in the garage, you usually put something down on a rag like the paint thinner. Just going to take it, move it along the pan, be sure not to burn my hand. Probably needs a little bit more. Be quicker to pour directly on the pan, but you're going to try to minimize the amount of oil you use. This is an olive oil, so it is a healthy oil at least, but you don't want it to stick, but you don't want it to absorb a ton of oil. So from here, I'm going to take just an ordinary piece of haddock. This was actually a piece that probably should have waited for the pan to heat up because there's no sizzle, but this was actually a full-length fillet. I've chopped them in half. By doing that, I actually portioned out maybe a 2-ounce piece. I could cook the whole thing, but I just want a small taste of fish. Plus, if it's in smaller pieces, it's more manageable to flip. For seasoning, it's going to be simple. I'm just going to add some pepper, a little bit of salt, but not much. And I'm going to be risky. I'm going to try a little bit of cayenne pepper. That might come back to haunt me, but I'm going to give her a try. Now I have a little bit of a sizzle going with my fish. I'm just going to leave it there, maybe about a minute, maybe two, not long. From there, then I'm going to flip it, and then I'm going to actually try something different. I'm going to try to create a bit of a seal of steam. So let me just see if we got this ready to flip yet. Again, I apologize, I'm left-handed, and my kitchen's not very big, so I only have so many places I can put the camera. So let's see, flip her over. There's no brown there, but you can see it's nice and white, which means that side of the fish is cooked. I'm going to repeat my steps here. A little bit of pepper. A little bit of salt. And some cayenne pepper. So that I can curse this a little later on. So, I'm going to make sure my heat's not too high. I'm going to take a little bit of water. It's going to create a steam. Now, I'm going to take a lid from a pot, put that over my fish. Now, what that's going to do is that water in there is going to create a steam. The steam is going to help cook the fish. I want the fish to cook. I want it to be delicate, but I don't want it to burn. So I'm just going to leave that maybe 2 minutes, and then we're going to be ready for the plate. All right, it is time to get this to the dinner table. So I'm going to start off with my steamed Brussels sprouts. So that was about a cup worth. Now let's face it, Brussels sprouts taste pretty bad. There's no way of sugarcoating it. So do yourself a favor, if you're counting points, allow yourself enough time to or enough points to have yourself some butter or some margarine, You want to get as many healthy things in as you possibly can. They don't all taste great, but they're a whole lot better for you than having a package of the noodles that you get that you just add the water. Those are loaded with salt and fat. At least there, the vegetable itself is virtually nothing points wise. You got yourself maybe a point or two just for the margarine or the butter. So you might as well, if you're going to eat healthy, you might as well do your best to make it taste good. So next we're gonna do the couscous. I've fluffed it a bit with the fork. It is now nice and tender. I've left it on the heat a little too long. It's stuck to the bottom, but that's okay. So I'm gonna scoop out couscous. As you can see, it has increased drastically in size. It is much more defined now in the beads. It's very easy to see that is much larger. So move that over. And last but not least, our fish. Our fish with the lid on has steamed. It's not a very big piece, but it is a portion. So you can add that there. You could add a little bit of olive oil to the top if you wanted. You could add a little bit of lemon juice, salt and pepper. I got the cayenne already there, but that entire dish probably took about maybe 30 minutes to make. From start to finish, not very long. So it's really couscous with some bell peppers and a little bit of salsa and vegetable juice. Got my Brussels sprouts with some margarine so that I can stomach it. And a little piece of haddock. And I could have cooked the whole portion. Gave myself a good piece of fish. But for me, that is a satisfying supper. That leaves me with enough room to have a snack during the primetime TV. So give that a try. I hope to hear some positive feedback again for these videos, and we'll see you next time with another edition of Cooking with Cliff.